Well, as you can see, the wind's dropped. It's 3:30. Feels a lot later. So it'll be getting dark soon, unfortunately. That's the only problem with this time of year, of course, is you've got about 14 hours or so of darkness. Which is a shame, really, but there you go. It would be nice to get another fish out before it gets dark, but if I have to catch them during the dark, I've got no worries about that either. And the temperature's dropped a little bit, that's due to the cloud coming over quite nicely and the sun going in. However, I don't expect the temperature to drop a great deal further with this cloud. It'll probably stay quite warm tonight, so I'm quite pleased that it's gone cloudy. Certainly, a couple of days ago we had a really hard frost and I wouldn't want to be out in that. Nah, that's not fun. Not for an old bugger like me. The only other fish that I've seen top is right over there on the other side of the lake a couple of times. I've seen nothing else top around this area since earlier, but that's okay, we've had a fish out. And I'm quietly confident that we stand a good chance of sneaking another fish out. Hopefully this time it will be a bigger one. There's plenty of them in here. Well, we just had a fish top very near the middle rod. That's good. That is a good sign. That was a very quiet top as well. It wasn't a hoiking out job at all. It just rolled gently on the surface. The trail of bubbles came up at about 4 or 5 metres past where my middle rod is. So, you never know, that might go screaming off soon. But it's nice to see the activity. And of course the other thing that I'm really pleased about is that my bait worked first time. I'm really pleased about that. Yeah, it's always nice to get a bait that works instantly, for sure. Well, we just had another fish top out there. It's now coming up to 4:20, and as you can see it's getting dark. But we've had a fish top about 20 yards or so out there, so again, not far past where I'm actually fishing. So you never know, that right hand rod might just go screaming off again. That would be nice. The wind's picked up again, I don't know where it's come from, but I'm keeping out of the way of that inside the bivvy. Yeah. I'll have to be honest with you, I'm not looking forward to the long dark hours. I'm really not, still. I'm pretty knackered, so I guess I'll sleep through most of it. With any luck, I'll get woken up, of course, by a one toner. We'll have to see. First time on the water though, and yeah, I'm enjoying it. And it's a nice water too, I really like it. There's an awful lot of features out there. Morning. It's 7 o'clock and it's still not very light, is it? This northwesterly has been hammering in all night long. And I've been bashed around by some of the branches falling. The bivvy, so it was a bit of a hairy night actually. I got an absolutely lousy sleep, I have to say. I don't find bed chairs comfortable at all. And I thought that 14 hour darkness was never going to end. So I was up at 6 o'clock this morning. conditions are pucker. They really are pucker. I'm surprised I ain't had another fish, to be honest with you, because they were hoiking out all around in front of me last night. Sounded like someone was chucking a dead cow into the lake a couple of times. So some big ones obviously hoiking out. Horizon looks nice. Red sky in the morning, shepherd's warning. I've just heard the weather forecast and it's going to be a bit like this all day long. Well, that suits me, I don't mind. Time for breakfast, I think. Definitely. And I'll have some breakfast, then what I'm going to do is reposition and bait up all three rods. And I'm going to take a chance out on the third, the middle rod, because that's pushed out about 30 to 40 metres out into the lake. What I'm going to do is I'm going to pile a little bit more bait into that spot today, and with any luck the fish might just move on it and respond. Or at least be dumb enough to get caught. Because I'm pretty sure that the fish have been on my baits. There's probably nothing left out there now, except my hook baits. Well, as you can see, we've got some friends here. They are a right pain in the butt, aren't they? They really are. Let's get some light. A right pain in the butt. I'm having real difficulty getting bait out here, I have to say. They're not getting them all. But they're getting some of them, the little sods. I would prefer it, of course, if they didn't get any. Wish I had a big gun, because I'd shoot the lot of them. They really can wind you up, can't they, seagulls? They're on you so fast as well, they really are. I'm going to give it a little bit of time and wait for them to bugger off back over the other side of the lake, which is where they seem to sit, and then see if I can't get out the other handful or two of baits. Well, I don't know where all the seagulls have gone. They've all disappeared, probably because they've had their fill. I reckon every handful I put out, only half of that handful got to the bottom, for sure, if that. So it was a bit of a struggle getting the bait out. They can drive one completely crazy, they really can. You mustn't let it get to you, and I didn't, I think, yeah. Although, at one moment I did think of going asking the owner if he had a shotgun. So yeah, nothing's rolled. I haven't seen anything show. Last night, like I say, they were hoiking out along this bank and I didn't get a single pickup. I put out a good two or three handfuls of bait, I think, on each rod. And hopefully that will be enough. There are a lot of fish in here. I've decided to do day sessions here. I've got the combination to the lock, so I can let myself in and out quite easily. And hopefully I'll be able to do Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursdays up here over the winter. We'll see. Obviously I won't be doing that every week. I certainly expect the lake to freeze over again. It did last year. But yeah, I think if I keep trickling the bait in and coming down here two or three days a week, there's a good chance of me catching some nice winter fish. So why not, eh? It's better than sitting at home, scratching your butt. Now, I'm the only person on the lake, as you can see. None of the members are here. I think they do tend to show up at the weekends. I don't fish weekends, as you know, so yeah. I think it's time for another cup of tea though, definitely. And another bait and roll as well. I still want to shoot them seagulls.